Hello, I'm Nicholas Hoare for Vermont PBS. I don't know whether you like dirty dogs, but I happen to think that when they get particularly scruffy, they get particularly interesting. This one is named Austin. He's 9 years old, and he gets coated in leaves because of his long, furry coat. We've tried to take a few off, but he's not the most clean of animals, but he's a very dear friend, and he's keeping us company this afternoon as we read a book about another dog. And this is called Harry the Dirty Dog by Jean Zion, and Margaret Bloy Graham is the illustrator. This is a classic, and I'm going to read it to you from start to finish, and I think you'll enjoy it highly. Harry the Dirty Dog. Harry was a white dog with black spots who liked everything except having a bath. So one day when he heard the water running in the tub, he took the scrubbing brush and buried it in the back garden. Then he ran away from home. He played where they were mending the street and got very dirty. He played by the railway and got even dirtier. He played tag with other dogs and became dirtier still. He slid down a coal chute and got the dirtiest of all. In fact, he changed from a white dog with black spots to a black dog with white spots. Although there were many other things to do, Harry began to wonder if his family thought that he'd really run away. He felt tired and hungry too. So without stopping on the way, he ran back home. When Harry got to his house, he crawled through the fence and sat looking at the back door. One of the family looked out and said, "There's a strange dog in the back garden. By the way, has anyone seen Harry?" When Harry heard this, he tried very hard to show them that he was Harry. He started to do all his old clever tricks. He flip-flopped and he flop-flipped. He rolled over and he played dead. He danced and he sang. He did these tricks over and over again, but everyone shook their heads and said, "Oh no, it couldn't be Harry." Harry gave up and walked slowly towards the gate, but suddenly he stopped. He ran to the corner of the garden and started to dig furiously. Soon he jumped away from the hole, barking short, happy barks. He'd found the scrubbing brush, and carrying it in his mouth, he ran into the house. Up the stairs he dashed, with the family following close behind. He jumped into the bathtub and sat up begging, with the scrubbing brush in his mouth. A trick he certainly had never done before. "This little doggy wants a bath," cried the little girl. And her father said, "Why don't you and your brother give him one?" Harry's bath was the soapiest one he'd ever had. It worked like magic. As soon as the children started to scrub, they began shouting, "Mummy, Daddy, look, come quickly." "It's Harry, it's Harry, it's Harry," they cried. Harry wagged his tail and was very, very happy. His family combed and brushed him lovingly, and he became once again a white dog with black spots. It was wonderful to be home. After dinner, Harry fell asleep in his favorite place, happily dreaming of how much fun it had been getting dirty. He slept so soundly, he didn't even feel the scrubbing brush he'd hidden under his pillow. And this dog is so sleepy, he doesn't even know that he's got a bone under him. And he's pretty stupid too. But he hasn't got black spots and he hasn't got white. He's just Austin. And Austin and I wish you a very good sleep.